Okay, and we are recording, so let me dive in. I want to do a speed modeling. Here we go. New sketch. Some quick avatar that we want to do for sketch layer. Do we do a surf layer, and that's about it for now. I do need to import some imagery, and I so hope that the image I have prepared is available. There it is.
Yeah, baby.
Where's the logo? Okay. Doc. There it is, people. Ravi sketch. With the Mount Crabby sketch. Okay, so we're going to do a quick avatar design. Quick avatar design for a project that we're doing. And I was going to use the female, I think might be good. Drop it in and go. Okay, so I need another layer where I can drop in my avatar. And then I actually only need the head, but it doesn't matter. Edit. Move the arms down. Oh! So it's sometimes very sticky when you're working away. Certain things are a little sticky. Just check real quick if we're actually... looks like we're good. I hope we're recording. Let's just assume we're recording and just keep on. So let's go to the head here and put on... switch on mirror. Basic mirror, surface contour, stage four, don't need that. And what I basically want to do is go sketch layer, or everything else, and kind of design this simple avatar surface. Phew, that's not gonna be easy. As you can see, there's kind of this thing going on, and then there's this shoulder patch going on. And what I really like is the ability to just go nuts with a surface. Basically pull this out here somewhere. You can also put stuff on top, it's good for your exercise. Low poly, something. Yeah, I think we're all set. And what I really like is maybe, you know what? Let's just dive in and go surface. Let's go, let's be bold here. Because the thing with this, the thing is that you can actually, you know, it is mirrored. Yeah, it should be mirrored. Let's just go for it. Because it is infinitely editable. That's the first surface. And we pull that a little bit backwards afterwards. And then there's this kind of second surface that's kind of this tennis ball flavor here, bomb. And obviously we want to go and smoothen that out from here-ish. But I would almost suggest that we build that separately. So then I just start with the chest surface here. And quickly just go and lay down a kind of rough chest. And basically what I would do is I literally just will start going bigger. Go in. Huh? Oh, sorry, that's what I did. And start figuring out these points. The last one is always a weird row of stuff that you have to dissect. I always let go of the wrong trigger. And if you do that, you, as you can see, they're starting to stitch nicely. If you let go of the trigger like that, then you will have some issues. There's always this extra layer you have to be very careful about. So now if you think, currently, we're just going to rough it out a little bit. And obviously, we want to make this refined, and later we'll add some other things to it. Trying to talk while we model is not my specialty. So yeah, generally, of course, we want just to be tangent. Now there are various ways to do that. In Rhino, I would drop it to the middle, And then I would collapse it out. What Emil told me was to drop it into the middle, and then I think he kind of snapped it in there and then scaled it out. I don't know what he did. I personally haven't figured it out yet. So obviously for your tangencies, you would literally have it pretty perpendicular, at least the first one. But in this case, I'm going to have to eyeball it because I don't have a trick for it. So if you have a trick for it, let me know. Like and subscribe. And like I said, I just want a very quick model here. Quick build to just kind of, let's say we... Well, if we connect this, so you need, now you need your snaps. Snaps here. So in this panel, you can select your snaps, but if you snap it, doesn't weld, does it? No, it doesn't weld. So this is, which one is it? That one. And again, you see this weird, gotta go in a little bit deeper to pull this apart. It literally is knitting. It's an old-fashioned craft. But for mostly, I just want to, at the moment, my main goal at the moment is to just quickly demonstrate a quick movie that I can drop into Unity, because I created a TV screen in Unity this morning in our environment, and I think this is a new way of working, right? So what we're actually talking about is, undo that, just a minute. And now what you can do is you drop a undo. I want it to be close. Which makes that one also immediately an other one there. There. Which I actually don't like, but okay. Now go towards the back and fix the back. So most important goal for today is to have a video that I can throw in our Unity space as a demonstrator on Monday, so that it's playing on the wall as we enter our VR space with the whole group. So we're setting up this Unity space, which is a beautiful environment. And wow, that is a fat hand. Now I know you can grab bunches of these and do the influence sphere. At this moment, I haven't mastered, let's say, all those things just yet. I'm just process. After a very good landscaping session last night at 12 o'clock, I'm kind of in the process of mastering simple stitching here, mastering is a big word, huh? But I just want to create a quick avatar so that can, and now obviously I can, we also want it to be a little friendly, so I think we need to figure something out with a more friendly, like Ray-Ban, you know, funny kind of thing where we go, okay, this is going to be our avatar for our own space, so this is kind of more of a joke for now. We just want to have a tongue-in-cheek avatar we can laugh about. Obviously, we will design a fitting avatar. If you think about HP, that will obviously be a lot more friendly. How do you make a friendly face? Well, it has higher eyebrows. The eyebrows are lifted. They are not going down. That's how you make a friendly face. So I'm not going to finagle it till the cows come home. The cows are already home, by the way. They're working from home. I hope the audio is working, and I'm finally getting into this. We're also having a discussion. Luckily enough, we have licenses, so we have support of Emil and those guys and Max of Gravity Sketch, which is great. And it's hardest is just to find time to dive in, right? And literally start doing some crazy stuff, because when you really want to do some cool stuff, you start actually, you obviously start doing some of this kind of stuff, right? Hey, that's interesting. Now, sorry, collect points again. Normally I would have them snapped already, but I snapped it together real quick. And there you see I have that double again. I keep releasing the wrong finger and then you get that double from the one, which is, it's not a big deal. It's a bit of zooming in and enabling. So the cool thing, as you can see, is like I'm looking at a statue that's like the Statue of Liberty size and floating in front of it. And I'm kind of like, yeah, here this does snap if you do that. If you do that, it does snap. And of course, the infinite extendability of these surfaces is the magic, right? That's really what here is just the unfathomable. And you can keep working on things very transparently. I mean, they really did, you guys. Daniela, hopefully, will speak indeed this week or so, but you guys nailed it with this engine and this UI, right? This is golden. This is golden. I'm extremely excited to be in this space, working away. And I think once you really like get the muscle memory going with all these tools, and you can transport your tool workflow that you had in other packages, it's going to be pretty insane, right? Now, obviously, you don't need this thing, and then I can play it in a different way. Baked, yeah, I guess so. Make it transparent. Visor. I just need very quick. But let's go back to surf. Visor is not necessary. But already, if you turn off the... Where is the avatar, actually? That's a good point. When I select something, it's unlocked. Do I know where it is? That's actually a good trick. Robotnik. Of course, Robotnik is fine. Is this Robotnik? Yeah. So as an avatar, we're close, right? We just want to have a quick save so that I make sure it is saved in the cloud. I used to listen to this album when I was a kid all the time. So this is our avatar at HP. This is just a quick... Okay, now let's snap this panel together real quick. Are those two lines? Let me copy. Just set my visor a little further and mesh. Of course, again, tangency is important here if you want to have the tangency. We do not have this one. But again, we're going for a quick mall to just demonstrate. Mostly this video. This morning I did a test and tested the gravity, the cyber cross track cyber truck, which was again was half an hour sketch. I generally don't have time to do like super intense ones, but I want to get up to speed and really start learning now. So again, a very, very large chest is probably not what you want. So now, if you move this entire thing, you can change the... Gender neutrality. Now let's see what we do with this thing. Again, say we pick the most absolute basic stitch model to make a kind of a avatar of this. Jean-Michel, I did it again. I hate those puzzles where you have to pull that stuff out all the time. I think I released the wrong, if you're not careful, they flip. So if you release the wrong trigger, that was my mic, sorry. Then what you get is you release the wrong trigger, and that's not good. Now that the... And will it snap? It will snap. Again, the mic. Sorry. So you can see that with this billing methodology, which is basically infinitely So here, for instance, what I do, I just go boom, 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 Robotniks. And on these, you can even scale, right? En straks gaat de boel los bij onze vriend. Oh, dit is Dutch, sorry. Yeah, anyway, so stitching this together and finding a way to make a very quick avatar that we can just have fun with in our own space. And mostly just practicing. So let's switch over a Robotnik. Ah, crazy. Now, of course, you want to split the body from the arm or not. That's the question. I'm not sure if I can hold the middle to it. Like literally go and again, you see how I just have to let go. You shouldn't skip, zoom in. Now, of course, you're painting yourself in a corner and you need to see the robot. Without the robot. It's a very, so if I'm in a room here, let's turn off the visor here. Obviously, you can start shaping the body and you need to trim the top off to make that black. Yeah. So actually, you can, what you could do now is you take one and you, I hate this. This is so hard. So you want to do is you have them both on each other and copy them. And now the original is supposed to move back. I still have so much trouble with this. You have to do 5 things at a time. I'm not very good at that. That's why I'm not an F6 in battle. So I grab, copy, and move, and let go. One more time. I think they're duplicates now, you see? Are they duplicates now? The way to figure out if they are duplicates is to move control point, and then you can see that they're actually duplicates. This is just where I really screwed up. And I think they're multiple duplicates, so I just keep making duplicates. And you can see, there's another one. So I still don't know. There's another one. And we're there. We're actually at the base of the original. Okay, so quick finish of the model. I want to copy this and move it down. I want to just create a duplicate. So I grab it, I hit press, and I let go. And it jumped right back. I grab it, I press, and I click, and I let go. And now it has created a copy there. As well as there, which is okay. So now I'm going to be ruthless and take all these points. Is that all black? That's all. Only the top is okay. This, let's say we and yeah, those types of things are just so now we have that, move that back up. You hold them over each other and you kind of move it back up to where? What? What happened? The whole geometry changed? Really? What? Don't understand how that happened. So what you can do is play back anything that happened and say, well, there's our geometry. And it doesn't fit anymore. Well, interesting. Go back. So we have this. And oh, I don't know if it's in circle anymore. Okay, hang on. I'm doing something wrong.
Drag, copy, move down, hit point, and release. And there, I did it. I have, so this is just me not having a muscle. And now it should fit over perfectly. I drop it in another layer, let's do that real quick. And let's set the auto serve to this. And we'll walk that. Serve. Two. Move that layer. Move that layer up. And this is now serve two. Can be become black. Moved up. And then ideally exactly over it. Doesn't matter. I'm kind of finagling it anyway. And now I'm on serve two. Everything else should be locked. It's getting very warm in here. There's no air conditioning. And what I want to do is remove this. Yeah. Then I go back to serve flippen and remove this. Remove, not move. Oh, sorry, wrong button. Now let's say turn serve two, I'll be at that. Turn serve one, I'll be at that. Okay, so what I still need to do is that one and that. Now I have my avatar. Right, now let's say we want to shape this a little bit. I think maybe not taking yet. No. This all needs to be a little. What if I can just. Less snap. Please. And quickly just make this a little bit less jaw, less of a jaw. A little friendlier maybe. Cheekbone. A cheeky bone. Now we don't have to do. Maybe a little bit of a head, a back head here at the back. What is that? Is it kind of, there's a weird triangle going on there. Okay, it doesn't matter. And then I would also grab that one and is it one? I'm not sure. No. Undo time. Roll time back. No. So I've made an edit and the time's not rolling back. Interesting. Let's just go and finagle this a little bit. Maybe again do the eyebrow where it's a little friendlier, a little more approachable face. As you can see, the facial gesture is maybe a little smile. Maybe, I have to always say maybe it's not such a. It should be a little narrower, the chin. Maybe it in a little bit. I myself have a very. Ah, this is the trick, you detach it. Smilish-ish. I have no idea what I'm talking about, but I'll do it friendlier. Yeah, that's pretty friendly. And we can actually, if we wanted to, add one more there. No, I would say undo. That is weird. So you have to, I think you have to go in there and then do undo data. So a little higher than eyebrow, maybe. Eyebrow, friendly. This is always an open, friendly face. So how do you create a friendly expression that's a little feminine, doesn't have to be, but a little unisex would be good, because you don't want it to be intimidating. Now you just snap those back on. Quick save! Yeah, replace. And our bot is ready, because that's all the time we have for today. So, boom, snap back on to full. The light in my room is not sufficient for it. And drop another one here. Click. Little thinner face again. Yeah, it's a rough concept, right? So concept stage here. And I mean, seriously, it would be very hard for me to have a chat whilst doing this and paying attention. Now it's way more shaped and formed than a humanoid is from Tesla, and I think the humanoid from Tesla is also concept, although those guys usually knew that the first time. So let's say, hey everybody, visor on. I mean, it's not very friendly, to be honest. Look. But like I said, it's a quick build, and it's supposed to be funny. That's actually this of the nose. If you do this, check this out. Expressions. This will be a lot nicer. It's as if it goes over the nose, right? Now what you could do is of course make a kind of big glasses out of this. The Aria, Project Aria, you can shape the expression a little bit more with the glasses. These are a little smaller, like a giant ski goggles, you know. And again, this is a very quick concept, right? It's just more of a... I'm not designing here, I'm learning. So it's for me a learning experience, not a designing experience. I mean, if you don't know to play classical music, you cannot play jazz. So first you need to, well, this sounds like jazz, improvising. If you don't know how to use the tools, it's going to be very hard to hit the microphone. Whoa! Shall we go to this point? See what happens if we do. Pop that inside as well. I mean, again, the intuitiveness of this once you're actually mastering. So the goal is to master this, obviously. That's the goal. Oh, this is pretty bad. I can kind of make it pretend as if it goes in here, right? By this intersection, which is an ugly way of designing it. But, maybe a little less evil, that point needs to go down. Okay, here's our avatar, hey you guys. You like our avatar? Do you like our owl? It must be expensive. Of course it is. Have you ever retired a human by mistake? No. But in your profession, that is a risk. Replicants are like any other machine. They're not a benefit. They're a benefit, they're not a problem. I'll check this out, guys. I'm gonna stitch these. Tell me, have you ever retired a human by mistake? No. But in your profession, that is a risk. Replicants are like any other machine. They're a benefit, not a problem. I want to see negative before I provide you with positive. What's that going to prove? Indulge me. On you? Try her. Of course, from that moment on, everything goes to the, let's call it, the AWILE, now, if you, did it again, try her, you mean, the girl, yes, why would I want to do that? So now I'm at the armpit section, it's critical, crucial, I have no idea, but that's the cool part, you see, you can basically keep stitching. And in this format, the chewing gum that they have to grasp your mind around is infinite. And that's the hard part of a gravity sketch, is just becoming a chewing gum person. But you don't have to. So now I have a little bit of a closed section here. I don't think we need much more. It'd be nice to actually do the lead-in to the head here. It looks like a nomad, which is actually kind of cool. A nomad from space. Okay, now let's just quickly do the neck. I realize that both of these need to move south. So hit the undo here. And both move them a little south. Make them a little slenderer neck. The whole head can tick backward, but I don't dare do that. So I'm just going to do this one. And finish it up real quick. And finish it up real quick with a kind of a... I cannot. And skip. There we go, we're actually singing people. Fun, as you can see, and then you can basically start connecting this stuff. And now please don't make it an extra shape, people. Down level. Don't want to be too sharp, but we also want it to be fairly simple. So there probably needs to be an edge loop added here that you can then move down. Make a little bit of a radius. So yeah, this is obviously far from any industrial design process. This is literally sculpting. And we're not even working from reference because. And there's our avatar. Let's make it black. Darker. It's the bluish dark. And that one then can be I call it a day. I'm also going to, here it is, it's a quick build, it's not as good, it's not as neat, those lines can be higher, but it's a little friendlier, question mark, and let's just also, you don't have to select it to export it, bake it, and I'm just going to export it, so, FBX, meters, I think that's perfect. Mesh double, and hit this. FWHP, go for it, and we're done. And throw it in. So, this is the first landing pad. We'll be at landingpad.me files. No, that's not where I want it. We're local. So I want the local. Again, all good, and hit that. And now it's going to be. Gravity Sketch exported sketches. Yeah, okay. Let's check this out to see if it worked. Sweaty man.